Hi guys, welcome back to another tutorial video, and today's video is about fixing the internal server error in Elementor on the update button. So this is the website which I was working on, and as you can see, the template has been built. We did multiple changes as per the client requirements, but after going like halfway done to the website, we are now seeing internal server error. And how it looks like? So when you click update button, you will see server error, internal server error. Let me zoom in for you guys. So this is my update button, and when I click on it, it will show internal server error. So in this tutorial, we'll be debugging this issue. Let's jump into the tutorial. So first of all, to test where the issue is coming from, we'll go to the system info in Elementor and see if everything is updated or Elementor is showing any issue in our stall, or PHP memory issue or WP memory issue. So when you go to the dashboard and click on Elementor and system info, you will see a page which will look something like this. It will tell you your server environment. So if you see any issue like PHP max input vars, PHP version, if it shows everything in red, anything in red, you will have to update that through your server settings, through your PHP settings. If you are using cPanel hosting or any other hosting you're using, you'll have to update that. So now I'm going through what the issue is. Now I see operating system, everything is looking fine here. We're using Hello Elementor theme, there's no issue with the theme. Now these are the logs which shows that where the error, why the error is showing up. Now as you see the error log, so if you read this line, it says allowed memory size byte exhausted. It means we are having issues with the memory. So let me share you guys the steps of fixing the memories issues with the Elementor and the WordPress website. So here are the three steps which I'm gonna follow. So first I'm gonna check the PHP memory limit. If we are, if we increase the PHP memory limit, whether it fixes the issue or not. And then we will check the WP memory limit to see if it's 256 MB. So that's the ideal memory limit which we should have in our WordPress website when we are using Elementor theme. So we'll check this. And the third and the last step is to check the number of posts and revisions in our WordPress website. These are the codes which I have added, which you guys might need if you have these issues. Now let's check out the PHP memory. In order to test the PHP memory, what I can do is add a php.ini file in my cPanel Find Manager. Sorry, not the PHP ini, PHP info file, to check whether my PHP memory limit is up to the mark or not. So I will go to the specific directory for this website and add a PHP info file to test the PHP version and the PHP memory. So that's the folder where all the files of this website are present. Now I will create a file to test my PHP memory. So let's create info.php. And in this file, I'm gonna add the code which will show us all the PHP details. So this is my file, info.php, click edit. And then you can add this code to test your PHP version. So let me zoom in for you guys. So that's the PHP function which I have added to check all the details in PHP. Now let's navigate to this file and see what is our PHP memory. Okay, so I'll go to the website and add in the URL of the file which I created, info.php. So that's how it will look like. Now let's jump into the memory limit. So that's a memory limit of PHP, which looks completely fine. I don't see any issue here. Now let's go to the second step, which is checking the WordPress memory. If it's less than 256 MB, I suggest you guys to have it at least 256 MB. Now let's check it out. We can check this in our system info in Elementor tool. Now let's go back, and here's our system info. And if you scroll down, you can see the memory limit here. So that's our WordPress memory limit, which looks completely fine. Now let's jump into the third and final step, which is checking the number of posts and revisions. Now this is the home page of the website, and if I go to any other page and try to edit that page, let's see if it works or not. Now if I go to any other page, for example, this is the single product page. Now if I click on edit with Elementor, and try to change something in that page, if it works, then we are having issues with the post revisions for that specific page. Now let me check if it's having the same issue with that page or not. So if I try to change the color of this element, click on style, update the color, and hit update. As you can see, it's not showing internal server error on this page. Now we need to clear the revisions for the home page to fix issue which is causing internal server error on the home page. As you can see, we are still seeing 500 internal server error on this page. So we have finally found what's causing the issue. Now let's clear up the number of revisions for this page. And in order to do that, we can add revision limit in our wp config file. So there are multiple plugins available to clear the number of post revisions. You can find that on Google. There's one plugin which, let me show you guys which one. So that's one of the plugin which you can use. It's wp optimize. This is the plugin which you can use to clear the number of revisions in your database. What I'm gonna do for now, I'll do it manually with wp config file, because I don't want to bloat my website with another plugin. So let's do that manually via wp config file. So that's my wp config file. Where I'm adding limit for number of revisions. Limiting number of revisions. This is the code which we'll be using, which will add the limit to number of post revisions to 10. Now let's copy this code and paste it on our wp config file. After that, let's hit save. Now let's go back to the page. So this is the non-Elementor backend, like when you click on edit the page. Current number of revisions are 323. Now let me hit refresh and see if our wp config code is working or not. So our code is working after hitting update a couple of times and doing the page refresh. We can see that number of revisions are now showing up 10 revisions which we set up in our wp-config file. Now let's go to the Elementor side of the page and see if a button is working or not. So this is our page backend, and let's try changing something. Let's do some text changes and now hit update. Boom, our update button is fixed now. That's it for the tutorial. I hope you guys liked the tutorial. If this tutorial gave you any help to fixing or debugging your Elementor issue, please like, share, comment on the video so I can create more valuable content for you guys. Okay, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Have a great day.